What is an arch? An arch is structure that spans a space and supports structure and weight above it. Arches appeared as early as the second millennium BC in Mezopotamian Greek architecture and their systematic use started with the ancient Romans who were the first to apply the technique to a wide range of structures. Types of arches. Arches have many forms but all fall into three basic categories: circular, pointed, and parabolic. Arches with a circular form, also referred to as rounded arch, were commonly employed by the builders of ancient history heavy masonry arches. Ancient Roman builders relied heavily on the rounded arch to span large open areas. Several rounded arch placed in line end to end form an arc such as the Roman aqueduct. Pointed arches were most often used by builders of Gothic style architecture. The advantage to using a pointed arch rather than a circular arch is that the arch action in a pointed arch produce less thrust as the base. This innovation allowed for taller and more closely spaced openings typical of Gothic architecture. Vaults are essentially adjacent. Arches are assembled side by side. If vaults intersect, complex forms are produced with the intersections. The form, along with the strongly expressed ribs at the vaults intersections, were dominant architectural features of Gothic cathedrals. The parabolic arch employs the principle that when weight is uniformly applied to an arch, the internal compression results from the weight will follow a parabolic profile. Of any arch types, the parabolic arch produces the most thrust as the base, but can span the large areas. It is commonly used in bridge design, where long spans are needed. True arch, as opposed to corbel arch, were known by a number of civilizations in the ancient Near East, the Levant, and Mexico, but their use was infrequent and mostly confined to underground structures such as drains, where the problem of lateral thrust is greatly diminished. A rare expansion is the Bronze Age arched city gate of modern day Israel, dating to CA 1850 BC. An early example of a Vasyur arch appears in the Greek Rhodes footbridge. In 2010, a robot discovered a long arch roofed passageway underneath the pyramid of Quetzalcoatl, which stand in the ancient city of Tutunken, north of Mexico City, dated to around 2000 AD. The ancient Romans learned the arch from the Etruscans, refined it, and were the first builders to tap its full potential for above-ground buildings. Throughout the Roman Empire, their engineers erected arch structures such as bridges, aqueducts, and gates. They also introduced the triumphal arch as a military monument. Vaults began to be used for roofing large interior space such as hall and temples, a function which was also assumed by domed structures from the 1st century BC onwards. Why is the arch important? The arch is important because it is a marvelous way to structurally support the mass of a building roof, a railway line or an aqueduct like the ones the Romans built. Some of the arches built by ancient Romans still stand today, and they offer a mute testament to the effectiveness of the arch in engineering. The arch is still in wide use today, and we even see big glue lamps in the shape of arch. The arch has a long history in structures man has built. Assessment of Maragola Arch Bright Case Study. A description of the bright Maragola Bright is located is in Asparaguay on the N2 road. This bright is good condition despite the enlargement of its roadway with a concrete slab made in 1990 that carries two lanes of traffic in one direction. The bright is composed of five brick masonry barrel walls spanning 20 meters. The overall length of the structure is 160 meters and its maximum height is 25 meters. The section of the piers is variable and measures 7.3 meters at the abutments of the arch. The piers are built of rubble stone masonry reinforced with ashlars in their corners. The bright was begun in the last decade of the past century. This first figure is plan and front view of Maragola Bright. This table, first table results from the geometric survey. Second table, average material properties derived from the testor Eschmidt. The first step in the process of the calculation of bright safety is the definition of the limit state function. In the simplest way, G may be written as G R minus C S, where R is the resistance and C the solitation. If G big than zero, the structure is safe, otherwise it fails. The probability of failure PF is equal to a convenient measure of the structural safety is the reliability index defined as where zero is the inverse standard normal distribution function. Different procedures are available to compute. In this study, the method used is form. Assessment assuming linear elastic behavior. The failure mechanism is defined as that where the maximum compression stress exceeds the maximum allowable stress in the masonry material or when the compression block in the masonry is not able to balance the axial load and bending moment due to external actions. Accordingly, the limit state function can be defined in the following way. This table is statistical definition of random variables. The actions due to the live load are obtained from the probabilistic model for traffic flow simulation that uses the influence lines of the effect under study. The average daily traffic is 2,000 vehicles with a This figure is modeling of an arch bright with the infill as a set of equivalent linear members. You can see rigid link, spindles elements, rigid elements, joints. After that, this figure is stress state of Maragola bright at failure. After that, this figure is load factor, a position for Maragola bright. This figure is deformed shape at a failure of arc Maragola bright. After a table is reliability indicates for special wedges in Eurocode 1 part 3 with and without concomitant traffic. How detailing this structure is working, I mean how the constructors are building this structure. The arts work by transferring the weight and load of structure to a horizontal thrust that is constrained by the rest on either side application. Arches are often built using this type of material, as many building materials such as masonry and concrete can resist compression. Construction and traditional masonry depends on the arrangement of arches on the opening of brick blocks or stones, which say wedge-shaped blocks called washers are placed on the side face with the upper edge wider than the lower edge. The downward pressure on the belt has the effects of the forcing the washers together rather than separately. The arch positioned in the center of wedge is known as the keystone. This arrangement means that the arch is usually self-supporting from below, but temporary supports must be provided until the timber of the form has been the keystone in the arch. To as a centering or centers builders rather than the inner lower curved arch is known as introduce. The upper curved arch of the other region is known as the extrados. The arch starts at the point of the arch or spring line the vertical supports to rise. How the transferring of the workload is working. Arch terminology. It is important to minimize the arch thrust so as to reduce the dimensions of the tie rod or to ensure that the soil will not move under the pressure of the abutments. The thrust is proportional to the total loads to the span and inversely proportional to the rise of the arch. In arches, rise to span ratio shouldn't be less than 1 over 8. A riser minimum should be 1 over 8 of the span and 2 over 3rd maximum. Lesser rise takes compression but not tensile loads. Loading in the sum total of all rotational effects produced about any such location by the external and internal forces must be zero. In three-hinged arch having a non-funicular shape, this observation is true only at three-hinged conditions. The external shear at the section is balanced by an internal resisting shear force that is provided by vertical component of the internal axial force. Designing for load variations. One of the most significant aspects of the modern ark is that it can be designed to sustain some amount of variation in load without either changing shape or experiencing damage. The shape of an arch is initially determined as a response to its primary loading condition. We see arched structures in block. There are firms related to these structures. Only GVA Engineering, American Bright, İçtaş İnşaat Sanayi ve Ticaret AŞ